Politics is quite the interesting thing, ladies and gentlemen, my friends, my cult of Sen. And sometimes it could be for the better, and other times it could be for the worse. In this instance with Mr. Young, yeah, it's for the worse. We're off to a great start, as you can see. Some replies were hidden by the tweet author, that would be Mr. Young, yeah, over here. And he's been quite an interesting individual on the Twitters. Basically, what's going on is, you know, there was a debate of sorts, you know. We were forced to endure it. It was pretty, it was a debate. Let's just leave it at that. Either way, Mr. Young, yeah, feeling very emotional nowadays with the political climate. And, well, I just want to read this tweet out for you guys, see if you can find what's wrong with it. To the few people, or the few telling me to stay in my lane, sincerely, go. Naughty word already. This could tell you a lot already about this person, but let's continue. Humans aren't defined by their jobs, okay? Gaming news and voice acting are my profession, but this election is my life in the country I now call home. This election is more in my lane than video games will ever be. Okay, so there's a lot wrong with this. I get the message, but I really don't like this LARPing that the e-celebs do, especially the progressive e-celebs, like Young, yeah. People like that, you know, there are a lot of pretentious people on the internet. Of course, there's only one realist guy in the room, that's me. That's why I'm not afraid to call this out like most people would. But yeah, I mean, I'm just saying, this guy is a huge LARPer, huge pretender, huge lefty. To be quite frank, I know some people that would follow this guy, right? And they've just lost a ton of respect for him because of his political ideology, because it's flawed, right? And here's the thing that's flawed with it, from my perspective, from what I called out, it's that this guy, Young Ya, seems to really be passionate and enraged about this stuff, right, when it comes to the political debates, right? You know, as you can see here, we have a nice little tweet as well, F Donald Trump. What a shameful and disgraceful display he turned this debate into, from the complete lack of decorum, the insensate lies, to him telling... Okay, here's the... You know what? I'm about ready to get into rant mode, because I can't... This is the fake LARPing that I dislike, right? And this isn't me talking from a Donald Trump stand perspective, or Trump stand perspective. Quite frankly, I'm just over here waiting for Kanye to run... and I think that the next main event in 2024 might be Progressive Rock Dwayne Johnson versus, you know, the second voice of the people. I'm the first. The second voice of the people, Kanye West himself. So I think that'll be a good main event. This Biden versus Trump thing was a little, it was a little one-sided here. But here's the thing, this guy, Young Ye's priorities are all wrong, because he wants to go ahead, and it's obviously the Trump man bad thing, right off the bat. Again, I'm not a Trump stan anymore, personally. A lot of the people that are that were standing Trump, and that were saying all these things without having any real knowledge on what Trump was actually doing, positive or negative, kind of, you know, killed the momentum for me. Of the hype for him. I still think that I'd rather be under, you know, his presidency rather than Biden's, because that would be a disaster. That's just fact. But this isn't me trying to defend Trump. It's just me calling it down the middle. Let's go over your tweet. Shameful and disgraceful display he turns his debate into. Literally, Biden did the same thing. I get that that's the anger from your lefty progressive side, right, that you want to go ahead and just put it all on Trump. But if you're being real like me, you can say the same thing about Biden. I don't know why you're deflecting that, but okay, lefty progressive. From the complete lack of decorum, the insensate lies, to him telling, yeah, here's the thing, politicians will always lie. For that matter, if we're getting technical with it, human beings always lie, except for me, because, you know, realest guy in the room. Here's why they lie: in order to gather sway and rapport from certain individuals, that's what you need to do. But for example, me, I don't try to do that. I'm just honest. And that's why I don't have the, you know, the huge following that many of the e-celebs do, because I don't need to lie and I don't like to lie. I'm just honest all the time. And that keeps me semi-active, you know, that keeps me a loyal, smart community. And I'd rather have that than a bunch of pay piggies like you, yongyea, who has a bunch of pay piggies as well. And you're targeting your lefty demographic with this disgusting, disingenuous, LARPy tweet of yours. That's pure cringe. I agree with this comment right here. Pure freaking cringe. And again, this isn't from a Trump stance perspective. This is just from a regular person looking at it. Your lefty progressive targeting could not be more obvious. Quite frankly, you are the exact definition of what the left should hate. A pretender, a nuisance, and just, I don't know, man. I guess he's big gay too, probably. Anyway, Susan, don't flag me for that, okay? I used it in the nicest way possible. Anyway, continuing on, you know, this whole thing with the telling the Proud Boys to stand by rather than condemning them. All right, but you want to point that out. Did Biden condemn Antifa? I don't think he did. And you know why? You know why? If you want to say that Trump didn't condemn the white, the Proud Boys or whatever. If you want to go ahead and say that, well, you can say the same thing about, you know, Biden not condemning Antifa. Do you want to know why? Do you want to honestly know why that happened? Because you don't want to alienate people you know that are going to vote for you. Because let's be fucking honest, right? Let's be real. We already know that the Proud Boys are going to most likely vote for Trump. There's no shame in that, right? Trump doesn't control that. You know, if white supremacists want to vote for Trump, it's not like Trump is, endorsing them or anything. You could twist it and try to pretend like he is, but he's not, right? But, you can't just focus on him without looking at Biden. He didn't condemn Antifa at all, right? Yeah, I mean, that's quite interesting, though, how that works. How, this is the lefty, progressive, fake, LARPing BS that's always around, right? And I think I understand why people that stan Trump get so, you know, they can't help but laugh or get pissed off by this. Because as a regular person, again, I'm not a Trump stan, but as a regular person, I'd be pissed, too, if my intellect was being, you know, spat on by this person right here. This cringe of a, let's see who he is. He's a voice actor, gaming news, reviews, and discussions. Yeah, stick to gaming news. I'm gonna say it right here. Dude, stick in your lane. Or you know what? You know what? If you want to continue to be fake as fuck, you want to continue to try to get your pay piggies to give you money by pretending to care about the country you're in, because let's be real, if you even gave a shit, you would have condemned BLM for the riots they were causing. But oh no, 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 let's not go there. You know why you didn't go there? Because you want your money, don't you? You don't care about the country. You care about the money that you can get from these people, from these lefties. You're a sellout. You're cringe. You're a liar. You're a LARPer. You're all these horrible things. Quite frankly, you're worse than Donald Trump. If we want to go with the Trump man bad thing, you're quite frankly worse. You're more shameful. You're more disgraceful. You lack decorum. You lie all the time. I mean, and if we're going to go with this, oh, he didn't condemn these people. Well, how about this, yongyea? Before you start throwing stones, how about you condemn BLM and the rioters? Will you do that? You won't. Do you know why? Because you're a fucking liar. You're a LARPer. You're a two-face. You're all that's wrong. You are part of the problem. Sadly, though, the lefties and the progressives will eat this all up. You know, the people that scream BLM without actually having any real facts or research about the actual movement as a whole. But, you know, sadly, there are more stupid people than there are smart people in the world. That's all I have to say for this video, guys. I think this voice actor slash gamer, whatever the hell he is, gaming news reviewer, is quite cringe. He's a liar. There's just nothing else to say about it. He's a freaking liar. He's a fake. And unfortunately, though, that's the way the world is now. And all this was another proof that if you want to get ahead in the world, if you want to be successful, you gotta have to appeal to the left, just like every other big corporation has. You know? Most corporations, there's a pattern here. They pretend to care about the left in order to gain profit. And yongyea and e-celebs like him that pretend to care about the country are gonna continue to reap the benefits. Also, that irony though. Stay in your lane, please. Do us all a favor.